That's work.
Yes.
Good morning.
I haven't 60 yet. We welcome you in the name of the Triune God. Pastor Buttons is on vacation. Thank you. Pastor Buttons is on vacation. Please take note today that during the Epiphany season, we'll be using liturgy setting number 10 in the hymnal. And may I suggest that you take the green sheet and put that in page 203. But what you'll notice with this setting is it moves rather rapidly. And so you need to be ready for that rapid fire. Note two other things too as we go along, and I will announce them. But note that the offertory hymn is As the Grains of Wheat, 465, not our normal one. And the post communion hymn is a hymn of O Lord, Now Let Your Servant, number 313. So just be aware when we get to that portion of the liturgy. All baptized have been called into God's world. God calls not just pastors, not just clergy, but also the youngest child, like Samuel in our first lesson today. In the gospel lesson, the call of Nathanael plays with the idea of place. Nathanael initially dismisses Jesus because he came from Nazareth. Where he came from isn't important. It's where, or rather, whom we come to. Jesus invites us all to come and see. Let us prepare for worship today with the prayer. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, creator of darkness and light, word of truth, wind sweeping over the waters.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. God, our right rock and our refuge,
we pour out our hearts before you. We have known you like our
oldest loved you.
We have wounded one another and sinned against you. We have not always recognized the Holy Spirit dwelling in each of us. Remember your covenant. Renew our creation. Restore us that we may claim your goodness to all.
Amen.
The voice of God is upon the waters. God has spoken. The time of grace is now. In Jesus, the reign of God has come near. By the authority of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are God's beloved.
Amen.
Let us join together as we sing our gathering hymn, "Here is Jesus at your word," 520. The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. And also with you.
From beginning to end.
For I have told him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God, and he did not restrain them. Therefore I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be expiated by sacrifice or offering forever. Samuel lay there until morning. Then he opened the doors of the house of the Lord. Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli. But Eli called Samuel and said, "Samuel, my son." He said, "Here I am." Eli said, "What was it that he told you? Do not hide it from me. May God do so to you and more also, if you hide anything from me of all that he told." So Samuel told him everything and hid nothing from him. Then he said, "It is the Lord. Let him do what seems good to him." As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel, from Dan to Beersheba, knew that Samuel was a trustworthy prophet of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read responsibly from Psalm 139. Lord, you have searched me out. O Lord, you have known me.
You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thoughts from afar.
You trace my journeys and my resting places, and are acquainted with all my ways.
Indeed, it is not a word of my lips, but you, O Lord, know it all together.
You encompass me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me.
Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it.
For you yourself created my inmost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb.
I thank you because I am marvelously made. Your works are wonderful, and I know it well.
My body was not hidden from you while I was being made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth.
Your eyes beheld my limbs, yet unfinished in the womb. All of them were written in your book. My days were fashioned before they came to be.
How deep I find your thoughts, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I were to count them, they would be more in number than the sand. To count them all, my lifespan would need to be like yours. The second reading is from the sixth chapter of 1 Corinthians. All things are lawful for me, but not all things are beneficial. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food, and God will destroy both one and the other. The body is meant not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? Should I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that whoever is united to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it is said, the two shall be one flesh. But anyone united to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Shun fornication. Every sin that a person commits is outside the body, but the fornicator sins against the body itself. Or do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, Lord, save her, oh,
you, O Lord.
The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from the Simon, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and all the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael says to him, "Did anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said to him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly do I tell you, you will see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Inspired as we hear and we read God's Word, the Bible. is encouraged as we pray and have a conversation about our faith journey with each other. And there we listen. You get challenged today that when you come forward for communion and you hear those words, the body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you, you've taken the elements, close your eyes. Close your eyes and listen for a moment. You hear the voice of God saying to you, you are a beloved child. A beloved child of God. We listen deeply for God has spoken. And you are day by day on a journey to know God more clearly. May we love you more dearly. It invites us to grow. What words there were in that psalm today from Psalm 139. Lord, you search me and you know me. You know my journeys. You know all my acquaintances. And I love those words, you're behind me and before me. Is there a greater love God can give to us to engulf us in his loving hands? You remember your catechism days? We all studied the small catechism by Lutheran. Explaining the Ten Commandments begins each explanation of each commandment with the words, you shall fear and love God. That. And he goes on to say what that commandment is about and what God expects of us as his beloved children. To fear and to love God. The growth process that we all go through. In the book Conversations with RBG, Jeffrey Rosen is having a conversation with Ruth Bader Ginsburg. And towards the end of the book, he asks Ginsburg, what's your wish for the next generation? And Ginsburg answers, the elimination of unconsciousable bias. The elimination of unconscious bias. She then goes on to tell her favorite story of unconscious bias. Back in the 50s, maybe even into the 60s, almost all symphony orchestras were male. And there was a writer, a music critic for the New York Times named Howard Tooman. And Howard would say, I can tell the difference between a man or a woman playing the piano or a violin. Now somebody took him up on that. And they blindfolded Howard. And they brought in a number of people, men and women, to play the piano. And guess what? He got almost every one of them wrong. His unconscious bias. Do you see it in our gospel lesson today? Nathanael's unconscious bias. Jesus from Nazareth? Nobody thinks, how can anything come from that small town? It's not Jerusalem, it's not the temple. He's already got an unconscious bias. We too must acknowledge our unconscious biases, be they gender or race, economics, first perceptions. All of those are preventing us from growing in our love of God. We need to grow day by day in loving God more nearly. To follow more nearly invites us to an encounter. Follow Jesus means there needs to be a meet and greet. We can't follow without having had that engagement or that relationship. And in our gospel lesson today, Jesus is calling his first disciples. Follow me. Come and see. An invitation is an essential part of each of our faith journeys. But today, we don't need an invitation that we give to somebody else, but we're thinking about the invitation that Jesus has given to each of us. We often misuse that invitation. Like when we use the phrase, I invite Jesus into my heart, which can result in a misunderstanding that somehow I carry Jesus around, rather than realizing the invitation is to follow Jesus. To read those gospel stories and see where Jesus went. To the undeserved, to the unclean, to the underprivileged, to the cross. To follow Jesus means we're called to go to the same places, a call to trust day by day as we follow more nearly. Recently in our Advent devotions, Carolyn and I were asked after one of the devotions, what would you ask the Lord if he offered you your heart's desire? An interesting question for today. God's invitation, God's call in your baptism is to come and see day by day. Day by day, as you grow to know that triune God more clearly, to love Jesus more dearly, to follow the Holy Spirit more nearly. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let us rise as you are able for our hymn of the day. 7-9 day by day.
Thank you.
Apostles' Creed. I believe
in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Encourage the ministry and mission of the church, God of truth. Let the leaders of your church be trustworthy and accountable stewards. Let all its resources and outreach bring hope and healing to communities. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Delight in the goodness of your creation, God of all. Heal areas of the world harmed by human greed. Restore those recovering from natural disasters. Protect our forests and waterways and all the creatures that live in them. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Call the leaders of every neighborhood and nation to serve faithfully, God of wisdom. Give them visions of justice and unity. Lead them to actions that promote equitable partnership and uplift those on margins of society. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Hold in your care any who suffer and struggle, God of compassion. You know our inner hearts. Be present with any who are oppressed, from racism or cultural bias, and all who long for respite or restoration, including those we mentioned on our prayer list: Chuck, Fritzy, Sandy, Pam, James, Kara, Christine, Ilsa, Tammy, Carolyn, Julia, Charles, Phil, Jim, Betty, Madeline, Ken, Louise, Sylvia, Tony, Caitlin, Arlene, our homebound family and friends, and the friends and family of Chris Yost, Lily Lang, Louise Ward, and Ida Gabrielli, along with those we name aloud or in our hearts. Give them strength and lead them forth with hope. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Give this congregation the anticipation and excitement of Samuel, so inspired and empowered to do your work in the world. God of unity, make us faithful as we build communities of inclusion and mutual care. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Trusting God who raised Jesus, and will also raise us in spirit and truth, we remember all who have died and are at peace among the saints, especially the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr., whose faithful advocacy for peace, justice, continues to embolden the church. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Knowing the Holy Spirit intercedes for us, we offer these prayers and the silent prayers of our hearts in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's share a sign of that peace if you are able.
Thank you.
Of heaven, We praise your name and join their unending hymn. blesses your journey day by day.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you on your journey of faith. Now join in hymn 313. Now, Lord, let your servant. love.
Thanks be to God.
Here we go.